Ladies and gentlemen, welcome. In this lecture, we will look at the basics of power electronic converters on electric cars. First, we will look at what is a power electronic converter at all. Then, we will look at the different converter types based on whether it's power AC or DC, direction of power flow, and the presence of isolation. Finally, we will look at the converters in an electric car and understand the concept of four-quadrant converter operation. A power electronic converter is an electronic device made of high-power semiconductor switches that uses different switching states to change the magnitude and waveforms of the voltage and current between the input and output. A semiconductor switch is the basic building block of any power electronic converter. We can see the schematic representation and real photo of a semiconductor switch. In this case, it is an isolated gate bipolar transistor, or called as IGBT in short. These power electronic switches are able to turn on and turn off at high switching frequencies ranging from hundreds of hertz up to hundreds of kilohertz. In other words, they are able to turn on and turn off within a half of a microsecond. The new silicon carbide or gallium nitride based switches turn on and turn off even faster, within tens of nanoseconds. In this particular IGBT switch, an antiparallel diode is included that allows reverse currents. The other commonly used semiconductor devices in power converters are metal oxide semiconductor field effect transistors, or MOSFETs, as they are commonly called, and thyristors. The most common way to classify power converters is based on whether the input is AC or DC and output AC or DC. That is, if it is an alternating current or direct current. Based on this classification, we can have four types of power converters, namely a DC to DC converter, a DC to AC converter, which is commonly called an inverter, an AC to DC converter, which is commonly called a rectifier, and an AC to AC converter. For example, a DC to AC converter converts power from an input DC source to an output AC load. The second way to classify converters is based on if they facilitate unidirectional or bidirectional power flow. Typically, unidirectional converters use diodes at the output in order to allow power flow in one direction only. In case of bidirectional power flow converters, semiconductor switches like MOSFETs or IGBTs are used on both input and output sides. A third way to classify converters is based on whether there is a transformer isolation between the input and output. Isolation in power converters is primarily required for safety reasons. For example, all mobile phone chargers are isolated so that 5-volt low voltage output is safe to touch, even though the input is from 110 to 230 volt AC. Further, the transformer used for galvanic isolation can have a different turn ratio between input and output that can help in stepping up or stepping down the voltage. This table gives you an overview of the three simple ways to classify power converters based on AC or DC power, power flow direction, and presence of isolation. Different types of power converters can be developed that meet a combination of these characteristics. Now, with this knowledge, we can look at the four main power converters in an electric car, namely the onboard charger, the traction battery converter, the auxiliary battery converter, and the motor drive. An electric car uses a central DC bus, called here high voltage bus in the figure, for exchanging power between the various electric components, and the converters are responsible for controlling the power flows. The onboard charger is responsible for converting the AC power from the grid to the central DC bus for the charging the traction batteries. Hence, it is an AC to DC power converter. The battery converter then controls the charging or discharging of the traction batteries by either drawing or feeding power from the high voltage bus. Hence, the battery converter is a bidirectional DC to DC converter. Similarly, the auxiliary battery converter is used to charge the auxiliary battery by drawing power from the high voltage DC bus. Finally, the motor drive is a DC to AC inverter used to control and operate an AC motor. The motor drive is bidirectional and feeds power to the motor for propulsion and acts as an AC to DC rectifier by drawing power from the motor during the regenerative braking. In some cases, the motor drive can be a DC to DC converter if the motor is a DC motor, like a brushless DC motor. This table gives an overview of the power converters in an electric car and their characteristics for AC and DC power flow direction, and isolation. It is important to note here that one or both of the onboard charger and the battery converter has to be isolated so that there is isolation between the battery and the AC grid for safety reasons. Secondly, both the traction battery converter and the motor drive must be bidirectional. Let us look deeper into the bidirectional power flow operation of the power converters and motors in an electric car. Any car needs the ability to both drive and brake in the forward and reverse direction. This can be represented using the four quadrant torque speed characteristics. The four quadrants from 1 to 4 correspond to driving in the forward direction, braking in the forward direction, driving in the reverse direction, and braking in the reverse direction, respectively. Let us now look deeper into this. For example, first quadrant operation is when the motor has both positive polarity torque and speed, and this results in a forward driving of the car. In case of third quadrant operation, the motor has both negative polarity torque and speed, and this results in a reverse driving of the car. Or, in simple words, the car moves backwards. In case of second quadrant operation, the motor has positive polarity speed, but negative polarity torque. This happens when the wheels are moving forward, but the torque is in the opposite direction. This results in regenerative braking, and the car slows down while moving forward. Regenerative braking can also be implemented for operation in quadrant 4 by extracting power out of the motor using the motor drive and to charge the traction batteries. If a DC motor and DC electric drive are used, we can generalize that torque magnitude and direction is dependent on the current magnitude and direction, respectively. Similarly, the speed of rotation and direction is dependent on the voltage magnitude and polarity, respectively. So, in order to control the torque and rotation of a motor, we need a motor drive that can control current and voltage of the motors, respectively. In this table, we can see the four combinations of motor inverter voltage and current polarity, and the corresponding motor rotation and torque for a DC motor. Each of these four unique combinations results in operation in one of the four quadrants of the torque speed characteristics. Electric cars, however, often use AC motors, and their control is more complicated than DC motors. In case of AC motor, the forward and reverse rotation of the motor is controlled by the changing of the phases of the AC supply voltage from the motor drive. And in order to control the torque and speed, a variable speed motor drive is used that changes both the AC voltage magnitude and the frequency in order to control the rotation speed of the AC motor. Generally, the speed of the motor can be increased by applying an AC voltage of a higher frequency. To wrap up, we looked at what is power electronic converter and how power electronic switches play a key role in their operation. We learned about different types of power converters based on AC or DC, isolation, and power flow direction. The four key power converters in an electric car are the onboard charger, traction, auxiliary battery converter, and the motor drive. The motor drive facilitates in controlling the voltage, frequency, phase, and current supply to the motor, resulting in a four-quadrant operation.